John Beltran back at Sunset Baseball Field in Brush where the Bead Diggers trail the Holy Family Tigers 3-2. Holy Family will send up Kyle Munoz, Devlin Granberg, and Jay Elliott, the 7, 8, and 9 hitters against left-hander Ken Garcia after a lengthy bottom of the first inning, which included a debate over an illegal bat, and Daniel Soto was eventually called out. The pitch, fastball low and away. Garcia threw 24 pitches in the opening inning. The wind and the 1-0 offering. Fastball is upstairs, 2-0. To the right-handed hitting left fielder, Kyle Munoz. Two balls and no strikes. Wind and pitch. Swing and a miss. Threw that one right by him. 2-1. The 2-1 curveball drops in, but just a tad low. 3-1 to Kyle Munoz, the leadoff hitter for Holy Family. Here in the top of the second inning, Holy Family leads Brush by a score of 3-2. The pitch, swing and a miss. He blew that fastball right by him. Just above the belt, it's 3-2. Garcia looks good here. He's just got to stay in control. He's thrown quite a few balls, and he has walked one. 3-2 offering. Swung on in line down the left field line. That one is trouble all the way to the fence. Around first is Kyle Munoz. He's going to be into second with a leadoff double. And that is the third hit of the game for Holy Family. That brings up the right-handed hitting shortstop, Devlin Granberg. Three runs on three hits for Holy Family. Two runs on a one hit for Brush. Garcia gets the sign. And the pitch. Swung on in line on one hop. And nice play by Whalen. Stabs it near his head. Throw to first is in time. Nice stretch over there by Tormolin. I mean, that was head high on that grounder to Waylert's left, and for somebody who's had very little practice time after coming off that basketball season, that was a sparkling defensive play, retiring Granberg as Munoz advanced to third. One down for Jay Elliott. I mean, there's major leaguers that do not make that play. Fastball, a strike on the outer half. It's 0-1. And that might sound like an exaggeration, but if you were watching what I just saw, that was a sparkling play. The wind and the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. A late swing by Elliott. The right-handed hitting center fielder. It's 0-2. And Garcia looks like he's starting to get into a little bit of a rhythm. It's that out pitch that he hasn't found yet. He's thrown a lot of swinging strikes. 0-2. Swung on and popped up down the right field line. Now Soto is way back. Misjudged it initially. Comes in. Makes the catch. Tagging up is Munoz. The throw towards the plate is going to be late. Scoring upstanding is Munoz. It's a sacrifice fly by Jay Elliott. And it's a 4-2 Holy Family lead. And that was a perfect example right there where Garcia had an 0-2 count against Elliott but couldn't get that strike three to keep the runner Munoz at third. Nonetheless, he did record the out, which is obviously very important. That'll bring up Rob McCandlish. Wind and pitch in the dirt with a fastball. It's 1-0. And one thing that Garcia looks like he's going to do here, especially if he can get McCandlish, is limit his pitch count here in the second inning. Wind and the 1-0 pitch. Curveball is in the dirt. Two balls and no strikes. The bases are empty. Holy Family leads 4-2 over Brush here in the top half of the second inning. Wind in the offering, and that is taken for a strike. That tailing fastball that Garcia throws got an excellent portion of the plate. It's 2-1. Northeastern Colorado's hometown savings and loan with locations in Brush and Fort Morgan is Equitable Savings and Loan. 2-1. Swing and foul tipped at the plate on another heater. It is 2-2 to the Holy Family catcher, Rob McCandlish. Temperature definitely dropping here in Brush. The Bee Diggers are down by 2 in the second. And the pitch low with a fastball. 3-2. That's been the issue here so far. This is the third full count that Garcia's encountered, and it's only the 10th batter he's faced in the game. The pitch way upstairs and outside. He walked him. McCandlish reaches for a second time. That'll bring up Ryan Silva, the opposing pitcher. Silva walked and scored in that three-run first inning. Stretch by Garcia. And the pitch runner going. Got a great jump, swung on, foul. Look out over there towards the Digger dugout. And it's 0-1. Yeah, because of the mess we had in the bottom of the first inning with the use of an illegal bat, a discussion that lasted 15 minutes. That's where we stand right now. The pitch with a game that's gone on for about 40-some-odd minutes and not even an inning and a half in the books. No balls, one strike, one on, one in, throw back to first, back and diving is McCandlish. Holy Family leads 4-2. The stretch. And the pitch. Swung on and grounded up the middle. The shortstop, Waylert, has it. Goes to his knees. Steps on the bag. Out. Oh, just in time to get McCandlish, who nearly made it ahead of the Waylert step of the second base bag. Nonetheless, in the inning. One run on one hit. No errors and a man left. An inning and a half complete from Sunset Baseball Field in Brush. It's Holy Family 4, Brush 2 on 1010 KSIR and KSIR.com. Holy Family 4, Brush 2. As we head to the bottom of the second, John Beltran with you from Sunset Baseball Field in Brush. Lefty against lefty, Ryan Silva against Ken Garcia for his first at-bat of the season. Wine in the pitch. And the curveball is low. One ball and no strikes to the sophomore. The pitch swung on and lined and caught by the shortstop, Devlin Granberg. Caught that one just about eye high, and there's one down. Garcia hit it very hard, but unfortunately for him in the wrong spot. Here's Mitch Tormolin, the Bee Digger first baseman. Another big, strong sophomore stepping in. And the pitch from Silva. Curveball drops in low. One ball and no strikes. Both Garcia and Silva throw a similar breaking ball. Tormolin awaits the pitch. Swing and a miss on a bender that fooled him. Would have been ball two. But the count is level at 1-1. But again, for Mitch, like some of these other players, their first at bat of the season. The offering. Curveball is hit deep into left center field. Way back there is Elliott towards the track. Reaches up. It's over his glove. Around first is Tormolin, and he's into second with a one-out double. Boy, this has been very impressive by these Bee Diggers getting their first at-bats of the season. Mares walked. Colby Waylert hit a fly ball into deep right field. Ken Garcia lined to short, and Mitch Tormolin hits a one-out double. Here's Dylan Acosta, the Bee Digger center fielder, another right-handed hitter in this lineup. So Brush has two hits in the game, both doubles, both in the same area. Silva looks in, looks back. Pitch to Acosta, and that fastball tails in the outside corner for a strike. And it's 0-1. Northern Colorado did lose today to San Diego State in the opening round of the NCAA tournament. San Diego State won 68-50. 0-1 pitch, swung on in line into right field. Oncoming is Herb. He's going to play it on a hop. And to third base is going to be Tormolin. It'll be first and third for the Bee Diggers. And that'll bring up Trevor Blake. So the Bee Diggers have two hits in the inning. Blake struck out in the opening inning. On a 1-2 breaking ball, he'll have to adjust to that. And this plate appearance against the left-hander Ryan Silva, the Bee Diggers are hitting him hard. Unfortunately, Holy Family is swinging the bat well on their side. So here is Blake. Runners take their leads, the stretch. And the offering. The curveball drops in beautifully for a strike at the knees. No balls and one strike to the Bee Digger catcher. Holy Family's in the lead, 4-2 over Brush. But the Bee Diggers are threatening. Pitch from Silva. Curveball is tapped foul up the third base side towards the Digger dugout. And a count is at 0-2. With Gregory Mayers on deck. Tormolin at third. Acosta at first. McCandlish lays down the sign. 0-2 runner going. Swing and a miss. No throw to second. Blake strikes out. Two runners in scoring position for Gregory Mayers. So give Acosta the stolen base. And Mayers can tie it with a base hit in the outfield. And that Silva fastball was just tailing away and tough to hit for Blake. And Mayers drew a walk and he scored on the two-run double from Hansen. In the first, the pitch. Curveball is fouled off to the right over the Holy Family dugout. And it's 0-1. Committed to serving those in production ag. Premier Farm Credit is the gold standard in ag lending. No balls, one strike, two on, two out. In the bottom of the second, Holy Family leads 4-2. Wind and pitch. The slow curve is in the dirt, blocked by McCandlish, and the count is level at one ball and one strike. One ball, one strike. McCandlish again lays down the sign. And the pitch. And that floater's outside. Ball two, strike one to the Bee Diggers' second baseman, Gregory Mayers. The 2-1 pitch. Swung on and lined. And that is into right field for a base hit. Beyond the lunging second baseman, one run is in as Tormolin scores. It's an RBI single for Gregory Mayers, who took a sting with that one. And the Bee Diggers are to within one. It's 4-3. Yeah, De Herrera lunged a little bit to his left. Couldn't come up with a play, and Mayers credited with a base hit. That'll bring up Christian Valles as the Bee Diggers draw to within one. Acosta had to hold up at third. The Bee Diggers now have three hits in the inning. Valles reached on a fielder's choice in the first and later scored. Silva looks in for the sign. And the pitch. And that curveball is up and away. One ball and no strikes. Garcia's thrown 42 pitches. And Silva, obviously less than that. Swung on and lined into right field. That's a base hit. Acosta's going to score to second base as Mayers. And on the RBI single from Christian Valles, the Bee Diggers have tied this game at four in the bottom of the second inning. Four hits in the inning for Brush. That'll bring up Shea Hansen, who golfed a two-run double into straightaway center in his first at-bat. Mayers leads off of second. At first is Valles. The stretch by Silva. And the pitch. That is a little bit low on the off-speed pitch. Thought he had a strike. It's 1-0. Daniel Soto's on deck. He was called out after the bat was deemed illegal. The pitch. In the dirt, and it gets away from McCandlish, but just about a foot to his right. No advancement by either runner. It's 2-0. Well, we've had slow, long games before. This could be another one if the offenses continue to produce like this. 2-0. And the pitch from Silva. Swung on and fouled back. Challenged him with a fastball. And Hansen was just a little bit behind it. It's 2-1. On a cold, slightly windy afternoon at Brush at Sunset Baseball Field. Two balls and one strike. The pitch swung on. That ball is belted into left center field for a base hit, and that one's rolling all the way to the fence. Mayers is around third. He will score. The ball comes back in. Valles to third. It's an RBI double for Shea Hansen. The Beat Diggers have played at three in the bottom of the second inning and now lead Holy Family 5-4. I mean, that was hit on a line by Hansen. He's already 2-for-2 with three runs batted in. And let's see if that's going to be it for Ryan Silva. He has been tattooed here in the second inning as the Beat Diggers have four hits against the left-hander and now five in the game. So Daniel Soto about to step in for Brush. Yeah, and these base hits have, especially the ones by Hansen, have been hit hard. And I think they're going to keep Silva in there. Head coach Mark Cowell discussing that out there. Yeah, Holy Family only lost to Eaton 3-1 at Coors Field on Saturday. But today, not as much pitching success. Here comes Soto. He can drive in a couple more, and the Beat Diggers would have a big inning here. Here's the wind by Ryan Silva. Well, anticipating the windup, and here it is with the first pitch to Soto. Swung on and lined into right field, and that is caught. Oh, a lunging catch by the first baseman, Garrett West. The ball was apparently hit off the end of the bat and headed for right field, but West makes the catch, and the inning is over. Beat Diggers scored three runs on four hits. There were no errors, and two men left in scoring position. Let's head to the third. It's Brush 5, Holy Family 4 on 1010 KSIR and KSIR.com.